It is currently natural selection season. And in the last 2 years at natural selection, I have been unstoppable. I am 2-0 in the big team battle. There is not a single person back there that can construct a team that will even rival mine.
Challenge anybody to formulate a team to face the Wabash Talentless Agency at Natural Selection, right?
We will come through that curtain. We will come in like a wrecking ball.
Can the darkness of his soul be overcome? Is this the man to put an end to his tyranny?
Here comes a time where you have to be held accountable for your action.
Defy destiny.
Cheat.
Fate. Sidestep certain damnation. Survive. What are you willing to do to survive?
Folks, standing by here with the self-proclaimed, self-made monster, Alex Castle. And tonight, you square off in the ring against a behemoth of a man, 347 pounds, who answered your open challenge last week, but yet you felt the need to walk out on him.
See, I issued the open challenge for a fight, and I didn't intend for that fight to be with some 350-pound, long-haired ape man. I wanted a normal fight. A fight like somebody in my weight class, maybe. That's what I wanted. I didn't want Frank Wyatt. I didn't ask for Frank Wyatt. If I wanted to fight Frank Wyatt, I would have asked him to come out by name. I'm not afraid of anybody. But you understand, in the game of fighting, it doesn't just work like that. You ever see in a UFC fight, the champion's going to put the belt on the line, and then somebody gets hurt? The guy that steps in doesn't just get the title fight. He gets an exhibition fight. If he wins, maybe he gets a title shot. See, that's what this is like. Frank Wyatt had to get in the ring and prove to me that he was worth a real fight. Tonight, we'll see if he can handle a real fight.
If it's a fight he wants, I think you're going to get it. Folks, standing by here with a man who's going to be in action tonight. Of course, I'm talking about the big Frank Wyatt. And Frank, tonight, you get your hands on Alex Castle, who basically robbed you last week of the victory that you almost had.
Yes. Countouts, I don't consider them victories. It goes down in the record book as a win, but to me, it's not a win. Tonight, Alex Castle knows who he has, Frank Wyatt. I'm going to pin him in that ring. 1, 2, 3.
Here we go, folks.
Ladies and gentlemen, the opening contest here at Natural Selection is scheduled for one fall and is a return bout from last week's edition of UWC Online. Introducing first, weighing in tonight at 230 pounds, is the self-proclaimed self-made monster, the new age punisher, and absolutely 100% not a chicken. He is Alex Kessel. Tonight, weighing in at 347 pounds, he is the guy that's going to cook Castle's chicken.
of the 2014 edition of UWC Natural Selection. I am Aaron Martin. He is John Stone.
Hello, Aaron Martin. How have you been?
I have been great, and I am doing even better now that we've got this finally underway.
Oh my God, you hearing this crowd tonight, man?
This crowd is electric. It is amazing.
Oh, let's not sugarcoat it. This crowd's psycho here tonight.
And why wouldn't you be psycho right now? We've got an amazing match to start this off with. We've got Alex Castle taking on Frank Wyatt. Frank Wyatt, very impressive ever since showing up here at the UWC.
This match all scheduled originally last week. Frank Wyatt answered an open challenge put out there by Alex Castle. And of course, just when it looked like Castle was going to be on the losing end, he turned tail and ran.
Yeah, that's what Alex Castle does. But you say turn tail, I say strategically retreated.
Oh, are we going to do this again?
We're always going to do this, John Stone.
Well, excuse me, I got some business to take care of. I'll be right back.
Got a little stare down here between Alex Castle, Frank Wyatt. The crowd really getting into this. Firmly behind Frank Wyatt. Alex Castle jawing with the fans a little bit, taking his time. Refs on a count of three.
Alex Castle doing exactly what he did last week. Stayed outside. He tried to get Frank Wyatt to follow him out there, and he sucked him inside.
Frank Wyatt does it again. He fell for it again. He rolls into the ring. Here comes Frank Wyatt. Oh, missed him. Alex Castle tried to grab the leg as he got in. Frank Wyatt saw it coming. Walked right over Alex Castle's back right there. Alex back outside the ring. Trying to gain a little composure. Frank Wyatt looks like he's having some fun in there.
Well, Frank Wyatt's always having fun, but don't let looks deceive you. This man can go with the best of them.
Yeah, he can. He's got size. He's got surprising agility. He's got talent. He's got it all. Looks like there's something wrong with Castle's leg.
What could be wrong? Could he have pulled a muscle? Maybe a ripped meniscus, a tendon?
Now he's trying to use that chair to get himself.
Oh my gosh!
Right into the leg of Frank Wyatt.
You see that? It's tactics like that that make Alex Castle exactly what he is, a self-made monster.
Self-made monster, he's also a winner.
Referee on the count of one now. Frank Wyatt down on the floor. He's
listen
got
to this crowd, Johnstone.
I can't hear myself speak. Wyatt's got to the count of 10 to get back in the ring.
We're at a count of 5. Can he get there? He's making his way. Count of 7 now. Slowly making his way to the ring. I think he's going to make it. We've got 8 count. And can he get there?
Oh, and Alex Castle with a kick to the head.
We're off the ropes. Took another knee to the head. Frank Wyatt down outside the ring.
Alex Castle's had this new mean streak ever since he was able to achieve victory over the real New Age Punisher B-Boy last month at UWC 6.
What a match that was, and he did pull out the victory against B-Boy. This crowd firmly behind Frank Wyatt.
This crowd loves Frank Wyatt. This man, this big man, 347 pounds. Been nothing but impressive showing up here back in January during the New Talent Initiative.
See, this is the smarts. This is what I'm talking about with Alex Castle. He knows that the guy, he's bigger and stronger, Frank Wyatt is, than he is. So what is he doing? He goes right for the leg, keep him right down on the canvas.
I'm not saying it's not a smart tactic. I just wish he'd find other ways to do stuff.
Well, how would you fight a guy like Frank Wyatt? How would you wrestle this match?
I wouldn't. I'd run.
I can't blame you there. Look at the size of this Frank Wyatt.
Oh, and Alex
still working on that knee.
Well, that's a smart move. Like a shark that smells blood in the water, he caused the injury. Oh, Frank Wyatt now battling out of the corner. Goes the elbows right to his face. Forearm shot.
Frank Wyatt fighting back.
Oh, and there's Alex Castle just to cut him off at the pass.
We got a little bit of a yes and no chant going here.
We've had some sort of a movement make its way through here. I'm not really sure what it is, though.
I'm not quite certain either, but what I am certain of is that Alex Castle is in control of this matchup right now.
Oh!
Stomp on
Look
the
Look at that.
The leg.
Alex Castle's no slouch in his own right. 230 pounds, and all that weight just came crashing down on Frank Wyatt's leg. Ooh.
He's really taking it to that leg of Frank Wyatt, and I can't blame the guy. If you're going to take on somebody that big, you got to do something, and taking out the leg is just the thing to do.
Referee Mike Underwood checking to see if Frank Wyatt still wants to compete here, stomping away.
And you know he's going to want to compete. He's not going to quit. Not this early in the match. Another stomp to that kneecap.
This crowd here at the Battle Zone in Georgetown has just been ready for Natural Selection ever since we first announced it a few weeks ago.
They've been ready, I've been ready, you've been ready, everybody's been ready for Natural Selection.
I know you've been ready, but I haven't seen you in a while, so I couldn't tell if you were ready or not.
Oh, I'm ready. And I apologize for my absence, but I've had other things I've had to tend to. I'm so happy to be back in the UWC right now, though.
Well, I'm not saying anything. I mean, if you want to take another absence, feel free. I mean,
is that the way you feel about it?
Oh, I'm just trying to look out for your safety, man.
It's my best interest.
Yeah.
As long as I know we're on the same page.
Forearm shots right into the corner on Frank Wyatt by Alex Castle.
Alex Castle has been really in control of this match ever since the get-go.
Well, ever since Alex Castle has decided to venture out on his own and break away from tag team competition. Running knee to the side of the head.
He's been impressive, to say the least.
Oh, he's looking to see if he can knock that man out. But ever since Alex Castle decided to break away and be his own man, he's had this renewed vigor and this renewed fire lit under him. And that shows, like I said, with last month's victory over B-Boy and this vicious beating he's laying to Frank Wyatt tonight.
This is pretty vicious. I mean, he's really been working on that leg, but he's thrown shots to the head. He's taking it, really taking it to Frank Wyatt.
Makes it back to his feet at 10, but Castle's there. Oh, and Frank Wyatt with a shot of his own.
Two forearm shots. That looked like a straight right. Ref needs to check that closed fist.
Frank Wyatt's doing anything and everything he can. I'm surprised he's able to support his weight on that injured leg. You can see it's causing him problems.
Having a little bit of trouble. Kick right to the face, up onto the third turnbuckle.
Oh, and driving his face into the knee of Alex Castle. He could have the win right here.
Going for the pin.
Two.
See, he didn't hook the leg right there. That was a mistake. He didn't hook that leg.
Frank Wyatt able to get that shoulder up at two. Alex Castle beside himself. Can't believe what's happening.
I can't believe what's happening. After all the punishment Frank Wyatt has taken, he's still fighting.
Frank Wyatt's not going to fight unless something big and major puts him down. Running shoulder block. Running back elbow out of the corner.
He's really favoring that left leg.
Castle's got to be looking to hit that ripcord knee anytime. Runs in chest first into the buckle. Wait a minute, pulling that knee brace down. We've seen this before. Oh, Frank, he blocked it. Look at the huge suplex. He's going to go for the pin. Cover. He got him. Frank Wyatt got him. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Frank Wyatt.
Up to begin UWC Natural Selection. Frank Wyatt coming out with the victory.
And that showcases right there. Frank Wyatt was denied the victory last week when Alex Castle turned tail and ran. But tonight, he wasn't letting Alex Castle go anywhere. He was getting the victory that he wanted.
Folks, I'm standing by here with two men who just last week were opponents, but tonight they're going to be together in tag team action. Of course, I'm talking about the Pumpkin King, Phage, and Man Crush Monday, Jason V.
Oh, John Stone! John Stone! If you're going to talk about us in a tag team match, brother, you got to refer to us by our tag team name.
Tag team name?
Yeah.
Tag team?
You got the memo.
Excuse me. Hang on a second. I'm not seeing a tag team name, guys. I'm sorry.
That's a shopping list. It's not even... Johnstone! Phage! Jason V! Cocoa Wheats!
Cocoa Wheats?
Cocoa Wheats!
Cocoa Wheats.
Cocoa Wheats.
Why Cocoa Wheats?
Cocoa Wheats can't be beat!
It's the creamy hot cereal, the cocoa treat.
whether you're big or small. It's lots of fun.
So eat Cocoa Wheats. Everyone.
What just happened?
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team contest is a special challenge match and is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied to the ring tonight by Bradley Dupree, attorney at law. Weighing in tonight at a total combined weight of 500 pounds, they are the team of the corn-fed beast, Bo Sawyer. Introducing their opponents. Introducing first, hailing from parts unknown, he is the Pumpkin King, Phage. And his tag team partner tonight, now being known as Man Crush Monday, Jason V. And together, they are Cocoa Wheats. Because Cocoa Wheats can't be beat.
I said some really weird names in my time, and I thought nothing would top when Jason V and Cecil Cerveza were together as Cookies and Cream. But now we've got Cocoa Wheats.
Yes, we do.
Because apparently Cocoa Wheats just can't be beat.
Apparently. I mean, I wasn't told this news, but I mean, let's spread the word. It can't be beat. We're gonna find out here tonight.
This is the first time that we've been able to see the team of Bo Sawyer and Josh Steele together in action. They've always accompanied each other to their singles matches. This is actually their first tag team outing.
One heck of a power team. You got the corn-fed beast Bo Sawyer, and we got the real deal Josh Steele. Two big, big guys here in the UWC.
Of course, this team, if you will, of Bo Sawyer and Josh Steele first started out because Bo Sawyer was unable to capture the UWC Championship from Harker, Dirge last month at UWC 6. And because of that, Bradley Dupree stated, I promised you gold. And if the UWC title is out of the picture, let's go for the tag titles.
It's not a bad way to look at it. I mean, he did indeed promise him gold, and I think they can get there. I think they can get to those tag team titles. But right now, they got to get past the rather unorthodox combination of Phage and Jason V, doubly named Cocoa Wheats.
Yeah, and think of it this way. It was just last week on UWC Online where Jason V and Phage were opponents. It was because of this and because of Bo Sawyer and Josh Steele jumping both men in that match that this match here was challenged, signed, and accepted.
No, that's all it takes. That's all it takes is one or
Wait
two.
Wait a second. I think we saw a tag there, but Jason's saying that wasn't a tag, it was a high five.
High fives, tags.
Things are crazy here tonight. Legally, a high five is a tag. There's a pat to the back.
Well, that's technically a tag.
That's a tag as well. I mean,
referee's giving him the count. Phage back in the ring. Josh Steele back to his feet.
Oh, and Josh still looking to kick him, but Phage caught him at the last second.
I don't think Josh Steele rightly knows where he is right now.
Josh Steele doesn't know where he's at, and Jason V and Phage don't know who the legal man is.
I don't even think the ref knows right now.
Nobody knows anything.
I do know one thing, that this is going to be a violent match once it really gets going.
But Jason V is apparently ticklish now. Josh Steele having enough with the games, wants to fight here tonight.
Going up to that second rope, Josh Steele.
Uh-oh, this is rather uncharacteristic of the real deal. He wants to crown him king. He's too far away. Blind
Bo
tag.
Sawyer bringing himself in, stomping away at Jason V in the corner.
Oh, just stomping him away.
The ref trying to break that up. Bo getting right into the face of the referee there.
Oh, look at the cheating. You could almost hear the sounds of Bo's foot connecting with Jason's torso right there. It's almost like they're screaming, douche, douche, douche. Double team tactics there on the part of Rough Cut. They're going by the name Rough Cut.
An interesting name, Rough Cut. Jason Beatty fighting back out of the corner.
Uh-oh.
Forearm shot.
Oh!
What a shot!
Jason V loves utilizing them big chops.
Oh! You can hear them all the way in Westville. Westville being a town not too far away from Georgetown.
On their
UWC battle zone is located.
This portion of the geography lesson of natural selection brought to you by something. I don't know. Josh Steele now just look at the power as he lifts Jason V up high to the sky and holds him there.
Look at that. They've knocked Jason V's headband off.
That stalling scoop slam going back to that second rope didn't work well for him last time.
Jason V a little closer this time. Josh Steele signaling the end.
And what?
Starting to roll away.
Well, it's a smart move, but at the same time, Josh Steele was caught off guard with that one. But he took too much time up on the ropes. He's trying to banter with the crowd.
He is taking too much time. He's showing off, and he should know better. Mr. Dupree needs to get a handle on his team here.
Well, I think Josh Steele needs to get a handle on Jason V first. And there he goes again.
He's giving him too much time. He's getting his wind back.
He's like a tumbleweed rolling in the wind.
Coco eats in the wind. So do you think he's getting the wheat or the cocoa?
You know, at this point, I'm not really sure it matters.
Phage gets the tag, and so does Bo Sawyer.
Bo doesn't see that Phage is in there, turns around. Oh, and he just kicks that arm right away. Standing in Zagiri.
Josh Steele still in the ring.
Oh, and Phage lighting him up like a house on fire there. Shoots him off the ropes. Nice, spinning jawbreaker.
Josh Steele trying to get out of the ring now. Phage taking it to Bo Sawyer.
Reverse gyroscope out of the corner, Phage sent in. Here comes Bo with that big massive arm and Phage gets out of the way.
He's up at the top, John Stone.
He's going for that double knee, it looks like. Oh, and Phage catches him at the last second. Bo catches him at the last second. Phage took that shot.
I don't know, as unorthodox as Phage is, Phage might have caught himself.
You know, I think this match is starting to get to my brain and everything's going all loopy.
It's in Coco Weeks.
Two. Only a two count. Blind tag.
Good call. This crowd is amazing here tonight.
Oh, exactly. We've still got a ton of action left to go here. Now, we've even got the big tag team warfare match. Team Harker
look at
and
this.
Team Wabash. Oh, come on.
Looks like Mr. Attorney at Law was getting into the action there. Bo Sawyer just pressing down on the head of Phage. Jason V is distracting the ref from his team.
And Phage's attorney needs to be disbarred quickly. I watched law and order. I know legal terms.
Do you really?
Actually, I do. Yes, I do. Oh, very nice.
What would, how would you legally call this right here?
I would legally call this, let's see. A beating.
A beating.
Basically.
Not assault and battery, it's just beating.
Well, assault with a deadly weapon, because Josh Steele likes to think his arms are guns.
They very, very well be. He's got a lot of power in those arms.
Stomping away on Phage now. So far, Josh Steele and Bo Sawyer seem to be gelling pretty well as a team.
Doing a little better than Coco Eats right now. Coco Eats. I can't get over that name, John Stone. That looks like a message to Jason V.
Oh, and there's one right back.
Kick to the gut there by Bo Sawyer. Strong forearm to the back. Oh, look at him right in Jason V's face. Goading him into the ring. Jason V's losing his cool a little.
That's
a triple team.
Yeah, look exactly what they're doing. They're distracting the referee so they can try and cheat.
Jason V is distracting the referee.
Yeah, but who brought it on?
Jason V fell for it.
Phage
is getting stomped in this corner right now.
Phage has got to find a way to get back to his feet and get over to his corner and tag the fresh man.
You can tell, look at that, Jason V really wants in the ring. He's got half his body in the ring.
Mike Underwood's going to turn around and see that.
Phage trying to get the crowd into it.
Oh, I don't think it's going to take very much to get this crowd into it.
No, not at all. Couple of elbows.
Oh, he held on to the tights in that clubbing lariat to the back of the neck.
Phage might be out of it.
Two.
One, two count. Just got the shoulder up. That looked like instinct, John Stone.
Basic instinct.
That's what natural selection's all about. Survival of the fittest. We're going to find out who's the fittest here tonight.
Sets him up on that top turnbuckle up in no man's land. Nothing good ever happens from the top.
Now, you can never really quite come out on top. Even if you are on the upside, it still takes a toll on your body.
Wait a minute, Phage able to fight out of it. Up to that top rope. There's the double knee! Oh my gosh! That double knee landed, but all of his weight came down on the chest area of Josh Steele.
Oh, he got the tag. He got the tag. Jason V's in the ring.
And Steele doesn't know it yet. Now he does. Oh!
Forearm shots. Three of them. Four. It's really taking it to Josh Steele.
Josh Steele reverses that wrist. Jason V counters out of that one. Nice back elbow. Shot to the midsection. Hits that kick to the chest. Uh-oh! Super kick!
What a kick by Jason V.
That super kick that he just called for landed on target. Wait a second. Is he gonna fly?
I think he wants to.
Oh, we've never seen Jason V do this before. Incoming! Suicide dive to Bo Sawyer on the outside!
Jason V is on fire!
And this crowd is going crazy. He's calling for one more.
He's going to suicide dive over the steel side now.
Oh, security better be ready. Incoming.
He caught him. He caught him with an uppercut.
He caught him with that European uppercut.
Here comes Phage.
Wait, but he doesn't see Phage.
He doesn't see Phage. He's jawing the fans.
Here he goes.
Suicide dive. We got bodies everywhere.
Bodies have hit the floor, finally!
Dupree is trying to get Bo Sawyer into the ring. Bo's not the legal man.
Dupree's up on the ring right now. Jason V wants to go for that boot! That running boot that he utilizes, it's coming!
Oh, he caught Dupree in the face!
I'm so happy right now! Christmas came early! Dupree went down!
Josh Steele just sent Phage into the tournament.
Wait a second, he's got that locked on!
What a move!
Oh my gosh!
Full Nelson powerbomb slam! Oh wow! Team Rough Cut coming out with the victory! What a match, a physical match! the victory over Phage and Jason V in an impressive fashion there in the end. That was a full Nelson to powerbomb.
Well, you can't say that they were given this victory. They had to fight for it, and they did prove here tonight that they were the better team. I have to say it. I have to give it up to them.
I guess Coco Wheat can be beat.
Sourdough, there's not much left to be said, but tonight's the night. It's you one-on-one with Jimmy Karryt. Are you ready for this?
You stand a chance, you don't. Leave. Leave.
Was that really necessary?
Necessary is a relative term, John Stone. You see, necessary and professional wrestling don't always go hand in hand. But what does go hand in hand with professional wrestling is athletes. And you see, there's only two types of athletes in this world. John Stone, there's only two types of athletes. There's a type that has to be held back from doing more, from achieving greater things, from pushing themselves too hard to the point of injury. And there's the athlete that has to be helped along. Dragged along as if a kid being dragged across the street so it doesn't get run over by a stray car. Sourdough, you've always been the latter. You see, a lot of people don't know this, John Stone. I don't even know if I've told you this or not. You get your hands. A lot of people don't know this, John Stone, but I actually helped train Sourdough. So, Kyle, before you forget your place, I want you to understand that I helped train you. And the reason that that's not common knowledge, quite frankly, is because I'm embarrassed. I'm embarrassed to put my name on that. I'm embarrassed to have you walk around saying, Jimmy Karryt trainer. You are a disappointment, Sourdough. You are now, you always have been, and you always will be. You see, when I started training you, I believed, I honestly believed, that you had that it factor. It's like boiling water. Water at 211 degrees is really hot, John Stone. It'll boil your skin, it'll bubble it up. It all gross and disgusting and will mess you up very bad. But it's not until 212 degrees that it's considered boiling. Sourdough, I thought you had that extra degree, that extra push that it takes to get you somewhere, and I don't think you do anymore. So no. No, I can't help you. I can't drag you along. I can't hold your hand and pull you across the street anymore. I can't help you when my hands have already been nailed to the cross. So Sourdough, one-on-one, it comes right down to it. In a contest between an athlete like myself, who has to be held back, and an athlete who has to be pushed forward like you, the athlete that has to be held back will always come out on top.
here we go with Jimmy Karryt taking on Sourdough. What a slap to the face by Jimmy Karryt, slapping Sourdough right across the face. Now he's goading Sourdough out of the corner. Pushes him back into another corner. He's really getting into the face of Sourdough. Slapped him again. Two slaps to the face. Jimmy Karryt playing a little mind games here. The crowd playing a little bit of mind games with Jimmy Karryt. Really getting into the head of Jimmy Karryt here.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm late.
Oh my gosh, wait a minute. Roll up. Two count. He almost had Jimmy Karryt there.
Almost did. Gets out of the way. I'm sorry, I was so late. Making my way through the crowd here. Aaron Martin, nice clothesline in the corner. Oh, and look at that. His momentum got the better of him, and he tripped himself up.
Still got the headlock in, though.
Oh, and he went right back to it and hit it.
Sourdough with the little rumble of offense in him.
Sourdough has just been dreading this day. You saw that was his girlfriend on the outside.
She's got a look of concern on her face.
His girlfriend Elizabeth on the outside. She was giving her man some parting words, do you think?
Parting words, words of encouragement, who knows? But it seems to be working because Sourdough is on a roll.
I think he's found his spinach, Popeye.
Near the midsection, Jimmy Karryt slamming his head off the table.
On tape. Oh, there goes the ring bell.
Wait a second. On the table. What's Jimmy Karryt going to do here?
He has got him laying across that table. We've seen him utilize the springboard moves to the outside before. He need.
Look at that.
Oh!
Sourdough just getting out of the way there.
Oh my gosh. Sourdough could have seriously been injured there. You look at the time that Sourdough has had in the last month. His former best friend Blake Reed turns on him and drops him on his head at UWC6. Then all of a sudden he finds himself in the bad graces of Jimmy Karryt. Cross body off the top!
He's got
into
the
a pin!
Two count, just got the shoulder up, Jimmy Karryt. Sourdough is really taking it to Jimmy Karryt.
As I was saying, he found himself in the crosshairs of Jimmy Karryt. Some people are saying that I was the cause of all this. I'm sorry, I'm a reporter. I was just doing my job. I saw a story and I went for it.
But Jimmy Karryt feels snubbed.
Oh, and now Karryt just lighting him up. Look at what he's doing. Jimmy Karryt has had a very rough time over the last few months. Nothing has been going his way.
Over the last year and a half, almost. He's been having a rough time of it. He's been kind of on this downward thing ever since he lost the title back months ago. Had the whole thing with Aaron Matthews, and now he feels snubbed by Sourdough.
Whoa.
He's right in the face of those fans.
Security needs to be on top of that one.
Sourdough.
Oh, kick. Look at that kick into a stunner. Could it be?
In one, a two.
Two.
Oh, just got the shoulder. That's three near falls. Jimmy Karryt has got to take the crowd out of this. He's got to stop worrying about what they're saying.
Oh, Carrot's gotten up. Oh my gosh, 540 kick.
He grazed him there, but that was enough.
Jimmy Karryt found himself a little more of a fight out of Sourdough than he was expecting here tonight.
That is for sure.
Two.
Oh, he just picked him up.
Oh, look at the brazenness of Karryt.
Picked him up again.
Here's the cockiness that Karryt loves to display on a regular basis.
I love cockiness, but I've said it before and I'll say it again. You should not play with people in the ring, and that's what he's doing. He's playing with him right now. It could come back to bite him. I'm going to dump him out. There he goes, right back
to the outside.
There he goes. John with the fan some more.
Referee Shawn Rife with the 10 count initiated.
We're at a 4 count.
Oh, here comes Karryt.
Slides out the ring. Got him in a headlock.
Wait, oh look, he's going straight to Sourdough's girlfriend Elizabeth. Oh, look at the sickness of this. Oh my God.
Punch to the eye. He's right in the face.
That's ridiculous.
Look at the look on her face.
Well, she can't stand seeing Sourdough like this, and this is ridiculous.
Another one right to the face. This is, even I'll admit, this is going a little too far. But we've seen Jimmy Karryt do some sick things in the past.
Oh, God! Oh, my God! He almost hit her.
Almost.
He almost hit her, and Sourdough knows it now. Oh!
Throws him into the ring. Really taking it to Sourdough now. Just heavy rights dropping onto his face. Is he biting him?
It's hard to tell anymore. We need to figure out if somebody can get down there, make sure Elizabeth's okay.
He is really taking it to Sourdough. The ref is giving him the count.
Come on, can somebody not get down that aisle and make sure Elizabeth's okay?
We need to make sure Sourdough is okay. Jimmy Karryt is all over him right now. Wait, the ref has called for the bell.
This match's been thrown out? I mean,
I think Jimmy Karrett's been disqualified. I'm not sure. Jimmy Karryt.
What the hell is wrong with this guy?
I don't know. I think something has snapped in his head. Look at him down there. He's laughing. He is laughing, John Stone. Elizabeth seems to be okay. She's getting up.
This is disgusting.
Sourdough is not moving.
I've said Jimmy Karryt was deranged before, but he's freaking weird now.
And to think people are blaming you for this.
I didn't cause this.
Look at his face. He is torn.
Good Lord.
Jimmy Karryt leaving the arena now. Finally. We need to get some help out here for Sourdough.
You ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? I know you're ready. I know you're ready.
Standing back.
I know you're ready.
I'm ready.
I've been ready.
Would you get a handle on your team, please?
Silencio!
Quiet.
Okay, can we go now?
Yes.
All right, thank you very much. Dickie Wabash, you are leading your team into battle here tonight at an event that you say you own since the start, Natural Selection.
2-0, John Stone. I've never lost at this event.
Is that going to continue tonight?
Yeah? What kind of question is that? Look at my team. Zero Hype, Guy Smith, Mark Vandy, Cecil Cerveza, and Blake Reed. Look at this team. Dare I say, you viewing on the DVD machine, that this is the most dominant team to ever be constructed in natural selection history.
First of all, would you please not put your hands on me? I got a lawyer. I can call him anytime I need to. That right there is on camera.
Call your lawyer.
That's on
camera.
Call your lawyer. Next question I want to ask you guys right now. You know the added stipulation for tonight's match.
There's an added stipulation?
The added stipulation that Harker Dirge is putting UWC Championship on the line. The man that pins him in this matchup could be walking away as the new UWC champion. What kind of dynamic does that add to your guys' brain factors right now?
Doesn't add any kind of dynamic.
Hey,
there's only going to be one other champ, and you're looking at
me.
The new... Whoa.
That's going to be
listen,
me.
Listen, Stretch, okay? You're a tough competitor.
Guys,
I'm glad to have you on the team.
Don't,
but if there's a new champ, if there's a new...
Guys! Who cares about the title? Who cares about the title? Whoever pins him, you're going to be the champion. Big whoop. I don't care. 3-0 at Natural Selection.
Now, if you've been following UWC online the past few weeks, you may have noticed a certain superstar, a certain fan favorite, has lost his smile. And the reason I have been absent the past few weeks is because... No. That's a good guess, though. Very good guess. I know. Gotta wrap that up. The reason I've been absent is because I was trying to lure this young man back to the battle zone. So, ladies and gentlemen, I have succeeded in my quest, and I present to you the good-looking guy, Travis Weir.
Thank you.
Konrad attacking Travis Weir in the back. Travis Weir returning, our reigning Horizon Cup champion, returning after a month-long absence with a R-Dub on the mat right now. Travis Weir firmly with the crowd behind him. This is like an impromptu matchup between Travis Weir and R-Dub. R-Dub coming out, kind of spoiling the big return, which was the huge announcement by our UWC Sheriff, Titty Nashville. And here we go with this matchup. Locked up in the center. Travis Weir powering him into the corner, clean break. The music hitting again. Travis Weir having some fun in the ring tonight. The crowd, especially the ladies, seem to be into it. Taking down the strap. Oh, no. Had a little bit of a second thought there. Going another lock up in the middle of the ring. Travis Weir powering him back into the corner again. R-Dub reverses it though. Now Travis Weir's got the reversal. Clean break yet again. Oh, a little shove there by R-Dub. Then out the ring he goes. Ref keeping them separated here. Crowd calling R-Dub what sounds to be like a chicken. Travis Weir here about to lock up yet again with R-Dub. R-Dub with the side headlock. Got him in the center of the ring with this. Travis Weir gets out of it, puts him in a side headlock of his own. R-Dub down to one knee here. Trying to power out of it, turns around. Looks like he's biting Travis Weir. Ref didn't see it, turns around. There he goes right again to another side headlock. Travis Weir trying to fight out of it. With a hold of the hair, R-Dub. A slap to the face. R-Dub slapping Travis Weir right in the face off the ropes. Oh, what a jumping kick to the chest of R-Dub. Big forearm shot in the corner. Up on the second rope now. Oh, he's just hammering him with those forearms. Oh, an elbow. Another forearm elbow. Shots and elbow shots. The crowd really getting into it. Doing a little jig and then another elbow. Gets jiggy with the elbow, then gets jiggy on the mat. Got a cover pin count. Close two count there by Travis Weir. The returning Travis Weir, ladies and gentlemen. Got him backed up into the corner now. R-Dub in a little bit of trouble. Nice shot there to the midsection. Shoulder. Oh, what a slap to the chest. You can hear that a mile away. Travis Weir backing up. Looks like he's gonna go for something big. Runs in but misses the shoulder block into the ring post. And I am joined yet again, ladies and gentlemen, by my partner in crime, so to speak. Near fall there by R-Dub, but my partner in crime, John Stone.
Well, don't sound so enthused. Joined once again. I'm sorry about that, Aaron Martin. This has been a crazy night. I've been all over the place. I got held up with some business to take care of, but I'm back next to you.
I'm glad to see you, John Stone. I mean, I can take care of this by myself. It's nice to have another person around. Dropping the knee right on Travis Weir. Looks like he's actually got a chokehold. R-Dub giving the ladies something to think about. Got a pin attempt of his own, hooks the leg, two count, kick out by Travis Weir. Stomp to the head by R-Dub. Jumping, another knee right to the head. Really working on that area of the body. Another one. Travis Weir taking a lot of headshots.
I don't think you know just how happy I am. Wait a minute, pin attempt here.
Powerful kick out there.
You don't know how happy I am to see Travis Weir back here in action, back here in his home of UWC. I was standing there when he decided that he needed to get away. I was standing right there next to him when he decided that he needed to walk away and regain his composure.
I don't think you're the only one happy about it. He's our reigning Horizon Cup champion.
Oh, look at this. Randy Ray just dropping down.
Two. Another close pin attempt there by R-Dub. Just got the shoulder up. Looks like he's got a little bit of a chokehold applied there.
Of course, Travis Weir talked about taking his mother to share. I actually already knew he did that. I mean, you kind of know something's going on when your phone goes off at 10 o'clock at night and you answer it and you hear Travis Weir singing with 1,000 screaming fans to a Cher song.
That must have been quite an experience indeed. Right now he's got another experience on his hands. This isn't Cher. This is the UWC Battle Zone.
Versus out of the Irish whip. Randy Ray sent into the corner. Travis off the ropes. Going for a bulldog. Randy shoves him off. Oh, wait a second.
A couple of elbows to the side of the head.
Randy was going to look for... Oh, there's a boot to the face.
What a kick to Travis Weir's face. Another pin attempt here.
Could have it.
Kick out yet again. There's been a lot of near falls in this match so far.
I'm it.
So Travis Weir returning. Huge announcement by our Sheriff, Kitty Nashville.
That man kissed me on the cheek. You saw it.
I wish I didn't see it. But it happened.
Jealous?
I am a little bit. He is our sheriff, by the way.
Good attempt.
This match wasn't scheduled, I don't believe. But we have it, and what a match it's been so far. Travis Weir coming back against an opponent like R-Dub. I mean, this is good for him, I think. It's good for him to come back against such a strong opponent.
Whether known as R-Dub or Randy Ray, whatever you want to call him, this guy is a talent in that ring. Do not deny him of that fact.
And the ladies love the hip swing.
They love it even more when it swings in the opposite direction. Oh!
That may be true, but they love it either way. And there, looks like Travis Weir's liking it a little bit right now.
I don't think he's liking that.
Kind of powerless to stop it right now. He's hung up on the ropes there. R-Dub jawing with the fans a little bit.
Wait a minute. Oh, just that springboard move brought the rope back into Travis's larynx, into his throat.
R-Dub looks like he's calling something off the top rope there, John Stone.
Well, this crowd is 100% behind the returning Travis Weir here tonight, the good-looking guy.
I'm with you, though. I'm glad to see him return to the battle zone. Wait a second. Incoming!
Oh, and catches him! Catches him right in the midsection!
Travis Weir trying to get to his feet right now, get a little bit of momentum going. Both men getting to their feet. Travis Weir with an elbow. Forearm shot there by Randy Ray. Another forearm shot.
Randy Ray just lighting him up here.
Reversal.
Here he goes. Both the ropes! Travis gaining that second or third win. We know he's capable of. Nice flying lariat.
He's going for the pin attempt. Randy Ray looks to be out of it.
There he goes. Two.
Looks like that throat's still giving Travis Weir a little bit of problems. Favoring it pretty heavily.
Randy really doesn't know where he's at right now, trying to regain composure. Travis Weir back up to his feet.
Just drawing energy from this raucous crowd here tonight.
He's stalking him. He's waiting. Here he goes. Double leg takedown. Oh, and Randy just gets out of it with an ankle lock submission. Very nice move there on the part of R-Dub Randy Ray.
Yeah, very nice move. He's keeping the big man off his feet.
Ankle lock applied. Travis Weir fighting with all he's got to get to that bottom rope.
I gotta tell you, I'm impressed with Travis Weir. He looks good. The last time we saw him, he was out of sorts, shall we say. But he comes back, he looks great.
Oh, but look at the position that he's in the ring right now. Randy Ray has got perfect ring positioning. He can't reach out and grab that bottom rope. He's got to find a way out.
He's trying to fight. He's trying to fight to that rope. And he can just reach out and grab it.
He's got it. He got it.
Randy Ray drawing with the referee a little bit, trying to regain a little bit of composure. Couldn't believe that he actually got to the rope there.
Randy Ray is a little upset here. He hasn't been able to put Travis Weir away. Running into the corner, into a back elbow from Travis.
Another back elbow. Travis really trying to fight out of his corner position here.
Randy almost seems like he's out on his feet. Nice headbutt that sends him down.
Oh, man. Oh, talk about out of character.
Wait a second.
He's going up to that top rope.
He's on the... No.
Oh, no. Oh.
Wait a second. What's he going for?
What is this?
Oh, my God!
He went for the moonsault and he missed it.
He went for that sidewinder moonsault.
He's got to be in a lot of pain, John Stoney.
Oh, R-Dub's just waiting to pick off the killing here. Oh, that huge lariat to the back of the head.
He's got the pin. A two count. Must have barely got his shoulder
he
up.
He barely did. We heard that ref's hand come down, but Travis just got his shoulder up. And Randy Ray, he knows what happened.
He is beside himself right now.
That was the closest three count I've ever seen in my life. Closest to a three count I've ever seen in my life. He's going to go for another one. He might be aiming for that Superman punch.
So looks like he's going for it. He's got that fist ready.
That fist is cocked. There he goes. Travis gets out of the way. Wait a minute. Goes for the rolling elbow. R-Dub counters out of it. Oh! Cutter sends him down.
Against R-Dub Randy Ray tonight, and he picks up the victory.
That's what I'm saying here. This is going to be a brand new Travis Weir. The good-looking guy is here, and he's here to stay. This is going to be a fun ride to be on.
All right, folks, standing by here with Team Harker Dirge, who looks ready for battle tonight. Tonight, you guys got the opportunity to finally end the natural selection undefeated streak of the Wabash Talent Agency.
Hey, we got a purpose. We're going to war, and I've got my soldiers with me, and everybody goes to war for a noble cause, and the noble cause tonight is shutting Dickie Wabash mouth up for good, and I'm so confident in every one of these men that I'm, for the first time ever in an elimination match, putting the title on the line. If any of them can get to me and pin me to the mat, they get the belt. But you know what? With these guys by my side, I'm not so worried about that. Right?
That's right.
Yeah.
You should be confident, because the last time him and I were in this event, I pinned Blaze Reed's shoulders to the mat.
We got
a win for Dickie Wabash.
And we won.
Now it's time him and I do the same thing and end Dickie Wabash.
Well, it seems I've chosen accurately, natural selection. D Dickie Wabash, talentless agency, you're going down.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the teams. First, representing Team Wabash Talent Agency. And accompanied to the ring tonight by their leader, Tiki Wabash. Introducing first, he is Cecil.
Selection 2014, Team Harker, Team Wabash. Well, I'm excited, Johnstone.
Oh, yeah, I was down in the middle of it. You can feel the hostility all the way up here, but not as much as standing in the middle of both teams who absolutely hate each other.
It is no secret that Cecil Cerveza wants that title from Harker Dirge. It's kind of fitting that they're going to be starting off this match against each other.
Wait a minute, Cecil makes a quick tag out to Guy Smith.
This added stipulation to this match paints a huge target on Harker Dirge.
Well, remember, it's not just this match. It's every single match Harker has coming up. Every match he's going to compete in, as long as he's champion, he's going to be defending that title and everything.
That is true, but this time he's got four competitors. I don't even know if Harker Dirge can surmount those odds, but he does have three people to back him up. However, Dickie Wabash is the X Factor. Dickie Wabash, 2-0 in these matchups.
Very odd because Dickie Wabash is also the X in most of his relationships.
Listen to this crowd, Johnstone.
They've come alive here tonight for Team Harker. Let's not forget, going into this contest, the Wabash Talent Agency and Dickie Wabash like to boast about it, but it is a true fact. They're undefeated at Natural Selection.
2-0 at Natural Selection. Looking to make it 3-0 tonight. Mark Vandy in there right now.
This is the first time that Mark Vandy has locked horns with Harker Dirge in his entire career.
Well, he's in for quite a treat tonight against Harker Dirge.
Irish whip into the ropes here. Powerful power slam sent him down to a pin. Only a two count. Remember, this is elimination rules. If a man is pinned or submits, disqualified or counted out, the match continues, but that man is out.
This match will continue until all four men of one team have been eliminated. Harker Dirge in control of Mark Vandy right now.
Again, when this match was initially proposed, we already knew two of the teammates that Dickie Wabash had on his side. There's a tag to Joey O'Reilly. Two of the teammates that he had on his side were Blake Reed and Cecil Cerveza. Of course, it was last week he was able to sign the services of Mark Vandy and Guy Smith to set up his entire team for tonight.
And what an impressive team it is.
Oh, nobody's discounting any of their skill in the ring. They're all very capable wrestlers. Oh!
Aaron Matthews with a recent victory over Guy Smith. In the ring right now with Mark Vandy.
Dropkick! And Mark Vandy, let's not forget that.
And let us not forget, so that's got to have a psychological advantage.
Here comes, oh, big bad Konrad. He loves turning it up to 11.
Well, he just turned it up right there all over Vandy's arm.
You remember it was just a couple of weeks ago where Dickie Wabash approached Konrad. Oh, dropping both legs across that arm. Tag now to Harker Dirge. Dickie Wabash approached Konrad because Konrad was a member of the talent agency before he was abruptly fired at the end of last year.
The original member of the Wabash talent agency.
And he wanted Konrad back on his team. And Konrad said, I got other plans that
night. He's got him by the beard, Harker does.
Oh, he's grabbed him by that protruding facial hair.
What's wrong with protruding facial hair, Johnstone?
He ripped a few pieces of it out. Tag now to Cecil.
Cecil immediately gets clotheslined. Harker doxing the ears a little bit. An abdominal stretch.
Very nice abdominal stretch. You don't see that one very much anymore.
Not very much.
Could see our first elimination here by submission. What is the factor weighing on the heads and hearts of Wabash Talent Agency members knowing that one of these men could walk out of here tonight as the new UWC champion?
Oh, the factor has got to be huge, but it works both ways, John Stone. A, it's going to fire them up knowing they got a chance. But B, it's going to make them a little bit more nervous because they have a chance to become the world champion, the United Wrestling Coalition champion tonight, if they can pin Harker Dirge.
Conrad front face on apply, over with the vertical suplex. Shawn Rife saying he didn't see the count. He never saw a tag.
Harker back in.
Well, I can see your point on that, but at the same time, is it too much for this team to handle? Is it going to cause somebody to break down at some point? Because all these men want the same object. They fight in this company every single day
for
the very same object. Very nice kick, you're right. Only a two count. They fight for their ultimate prize and glory, and that's the UWC Championship. Is that going to blind the members of this very same team?
No, and you want to know why?
Why?
Because of the guy standing at ringside, Dickie Wabash. He's going to keep them on point.
Well, you already noticed when I was doing their introductions, Cecil and Guy Smith were already arguing with each other. They started arguing backstage when I interviewed them.
Now, that's not going to matter. Right now, they're in the mass, they're in the thick of things.
Hard to believe it was 1 month ago where Blake Reed shocked the world, turning his back on the UWC faithful and joining up with the snake in the grass, Dickie Wabash.
Can you blame him? Can you blame him? He was on the losing end of so many matches. In my opinion, he finally stepped out and decided to join the winning team.
Well, look, there's other ways to get yourself noticed. There's other ways to step out. Every athlete in history has been in a funk in their career at some point.
But look at what Dickie Wabash has done with Cecil Cerveza's career. I think that he saw that, Blake Reed did. He just wanted to be part of that. Tag in. Here comes Cecil Cerveza and on Aaron Matthews.
quite to the side. Aaron Matthews recently returned here to the UWC. Oh, very nice. Returned here a changed man, says he's just ready to live his life to the fullest ability that he can. Went for that moonsault up and over on Cecil. Huge dropkick sends him down.
Harker Dirge back, tagged into the matchup. A kick to the face, side of the face there of Cecil. Snapmare takeover.
Oh, stomps him.
Stomp right in between the eyes there of Cecil.
Rakes his eyes.
Elbow to the top of the head, forearm shot. Listen to the crowd.
Wait a minute, reversals of all the Irish whips. Goes for a splash in the corner. Cecil moves.
Cecil, oh, blatant choke in the corner.
You want to know a surreal fact here, Mr. Martin?
Yes, I would.
I will tell you something right now. It was just a couple of years ago, might have even been last year, where Blake Reed, Joey O'Reilly, and Aaron Matthews were involved in this very same natural selection team warfare. But they were on the other side. They were on the other side when Joey O'Reilly and Aaron Matthews represented Dickie Wabash, and Blake Reed was on the side of the good guys.
I do remember that. What a matchup that was. And that really shows you the difference a year can make. In a year, Joey O'Reilly and Aaron Matthews, their eyes have been closed.
Oh, and look at that. Mark Vandy goading Konrad in.
Blake Reed, his eyes have been open, and he went to the winning side. You can't blame him for that. A little bit of double teaming there.
Yeah, look, there's Dickie Wabash getting his hands on Harker. And Harker, I hope you just clock him and send him down.
Like I said, there's that X factor right there. That's why he's 2-0 at these type of matchups here. Natural selection.
Guy Smith with a blatant choke to the ropes.
Guy Smith, what a specimen this man is.
Oh, huge spine buster there by Guy Smith. Could be a new champion. Guy Smith thwarted as becoming champion by Aaron Matthews. Nice clubbing blow to the back.
Cecil Cerveza kind of yelling in there at Guy Smith saying, that's mine, that's mine.
Harker Dirge has been a dominant champion ever since he first won that championship back at Now or Never last year.
And that's really going to be the thing. Like he hasn't been pinned.
Wait a second. There was a blind tag by Mark Vandy, and Guy Smith wasn't ready to get out.
Mark Vandy really taking it to Harker Dirge.
See, here's what I'm talking about. These guys know that whoever beats Harker becomes champion, and now it's starting to boil over.
I think you're right. We got three people yelling at each other in the middle here. People shoving each other. They're on a team, and they're shoving each other.
Oh, we're seeing a showdown. Vandy and Guy against Cecil and Blake. Dickie's trying to regain control, and Harker's gaining his breath.
That's a huge mistake.
Wait a minute. Blake
Reed sees it.
Busts through the pack and goes straight to work. Cecil stopping his own partner.
Mark Vandy now taking it to Harker Dirge.
I told you this was going to happen.
Now Guy Smith stomping at Harker Dirge.
I guess Cecil Cerveza is the legal man now.
The ref needs to get some order in this match.
Tag to Mark Vandy.
Shots to the head. Elbow to the back of the neck.
Wait a second. Throws him up. Two.
Oh, and a kick out by Mark Vandy.
Mark Vandy in his chauvinistic ways almost cost him there.
What a clothesline by Harker Dirge.
Harker crawling over.
Tag.
Gonna tag one of the fresh men. There's Joey O'Reilly. Gets the tag. Hops over the ropes. Ooh, nice shots to the stomach. Joey O'Reilly loves utilizing that martial arts background in those kicks.
Mark Vandy shoves him off.
Oh, huge jumping spinning back kick. Nice jumping lariat. Ducks underneath. Oh, nice springboard back kick to the face.
Joey O'Reilly getting some momentum here, getting on a roll.
Could be going for something big. Ducks underneath, going for a backslide. Takes him up and over. Vandy lifts him up. Oh, and he counters in midair. The dragon tail dropkick.
Going for a little Dragon Zord special here on the top rope. 450 splash!
You gotta cover one, two, three!
Mark Vandy eliminated!
Mark Vandy has been eliminated!
Guy Smith comes in, gets dropped toe hold. We're down to 4-on-3 now! Shot to the face, Joey O'Reilly with a tag in to Konrad.
Dickie Wabash on the outside can't believe what he just saw!
Camel clutch.
Locked in that modified camel clutch. He's taking it up to 11. Cecil Cerveza trying to sneak in the back door.
Shawn Rife stopping that in his tracks. Referee Shawn Rife officiating this match.
Oh, and he gets to that second rope. Quick tag there to Joey O'Reilly.
Kick to the midsection.
Oh, went for that spinning jump kick. Wait a second. Belly to belly. That's his move.
And Joey O'Reilly eliminated. Harker Dirge there to meet him with a couple of stinging left hands.
Both sides once again eaten up, 3-on-3. The champion taking it straight to zero height.
Right hand to the face.
You can see Aaron Matthews on the outside there. He was bouncing around. He's ready to get back in. Up and over with a backdrop.
What a big backdrop.
Could have an elimination.
Oh, what a kick out. Just barely got his shoulder up. Konrad putting his foot up there.
Oh, huge shot.
Tag in to Konrad.
You got to know the winning side in this match is going to have so much momentum heading into UWC Online next week. Blind tag by Cecil Cerveza, and once again, oh, I guess Guy Smith's ready to get out.
Nice. He's taking quite a beating. Cecil Cerveza with the stare down of Konrad. You gotta think, this has gotta be a little personal because Konrad was kicked out of the Wabash Talent Agency in favor of Cecil. Cecil with the right hand block.
Konrad coming back. Oh, and look at the jacket jiving. Jacket his jaw right now. Oh, look at that. Ducks underneath it, jumps up, drop kick.
Oh, and here comes the big man. Ooh. I don't know if Konrad saw that tag.
Oh, wait, look at this.
Right now, the legal man is indeed Blake Reed. Blake Reed.
Uh-oh.
Picking him up.
Oh, the deal is done. Moonsault off that top row.
Konrad is taking a beating.
Wait a second. Oh, this is his move.
Oh! Modified pile driver. Right on the head. That's it for Konrad. It is now 3-2 in favor of Team Wabash. Only Aaron Matthews and Harker Dirge remain.
Harker Dirge back in the ring. Took his eyes off Blake Reed and he just rushes right in. Harker stomping away on the midsection of this big 320 plus pound.
Aaron Matthews finally gets the tag.
Aaron Matthews been getting some upset victories over the last few weeks over both Mark Vandy and Guy Smith.
Guy's much bigger than him. But tag boy, does this guy have some heart.
Guy Smith now the legal man. Aaron Matthews brings him in the ring.
And you know that Guy Smith has been wanting to get right back at Aaron Matthews. Guy Smith called it a fluke when Aaron Matthews defeated him.
He has his opportunity to showcase that exact fact right now. Wait a minute. Grabs around. Crucifixion pin. Three. He got it.
Guy Smith is eliminated. Aaron Matthews eliminating Guy Smith, going right after Blake Reed.
Once again, we're down 2-on-2.
Guy Smith grabbing Aaron Matthews' leg.
Oh,
going out. What a big splash. Two, three, Aaron Matthews.
Oh, man.
Aaron Matthews is just eliminated. It is now 2-on-1 against Harker Dirge.
And look at the two that he's got to deal with.
Guy Smith is really taking it to Aaron Matthews out there.
The muscle of the Wabash Talent Agency, Blake Reed and Cecil Cerveza. And don't forget, this man's championship is on the line here.
Yeah, you got to believe that Harker's sweating a little bit right now looking at these two. These are three of the top stars here in the UWC.
Locking up now, shoves him in the corner. Blake ducks underneath it, does Harker. Forearm shots to the side of the head. All running over, clubbing Cecil. Here he comes.
Team Wabash not looking too good right now.
Shots right to the mush on Blake Reed. Irish whip out of the corner. Blake reverses the Irish whip. Harker sends to the corner. Blake going, running straight into a big boot.
Cecil Cerveza finally getting up. There's Dickie.
Oh, and look at Dickie.
He's up there on the apron. Shawn Rife asking him to get down.
Of course, Dickie Wabash going to do everything he can to make sure that he can keep his precious little undefeated streak intact.
Harker took his eye off of Blake Reed, and that was just enough time for Blake Reed to capitalize.
Driving that shoulder right into the midsection on Harker Dirge.
Uh-oh. What a shove to the referee.
That was a mistake.
Ladies and gentlemen,
wait a second.
Blake Reed, I think, has been disqualified by Shawn Rife.
Blake Reed put his hands on an official, and Shawn's tossing him out, it looks like. Has tossed him out. Blake Reed is out of this match. We are down to Harker Dirge and Cecil Cerveza.
What a turn of events this has been, ladies and gentlemen. Blake Reed disqualified from the matchup for putting his hands on referee Shawn Rife.
Cecil Cerveza has been waiting for months for this moment. He's been waiting for months for his shot.
This is it. One-on-one with Harker Dirge.
It can't be this academic.
The crowd going nuts.
Harker Dirge took all that punishment from Blake Reed, but he's still ticking.
So much is on the line right now for Team Wabash.
Wait a second, going for that buzzsaw kick.
He just landed it.
He landed it.
This could be it. This could be the end of Harker as our champion. Two, a kick out.
Harker kicking out once again.
What a matchup, John Stone. What a matchup. Ladies and gentlemen, this means everything for Team Wabash. They could have a title and go 3-0 at Natural Selection. Harker, though, Harker feeding off that energy.
The crowd here is just getting behind Harker. He's trying to feed his way back up. Wait a second, running STO out of the corner.
Two, a kick out again.
Kick out one more time, and Harker's back into it.
Harker starting to feel it.
Harker is ready. Harker's ready to go.
That endless amount of energy from Harker Dirge.
Oh, it's from the fans. The fans are feeding him this energy. Blocks the punch. Harker coming back with a shot of his own. Dickie Wabash on his knees on the outside, praying to the good Lord above that his man's able to pull out a victory.
He better pray to something, because right now Harker's on a roll. And right there in the corner,
double stomps.
Cecil Cerveza better do something, or this is going to signal the end for him.
Harker's getting ready to put him away. He's getting to that zone. He's getting to that place. Irish whip out of the corner, running back elbow off the ropes. Huge lariat sends him down. Knee drop off the ropes. Pin attempt. Somehow getting his shoulder up at two.
I don't know how Cecil's pulling this out right now. Harker has just been really taking it to him. And this crowd is so behind Harker Dirge.
Harker's setting him up on that top turnbuckle.
As you said before, nothing good ever happens up there.
Shot to the side of the face.
Dickie Wabash down there with a look of concern on his face for his client.
He's going for that superplex off the second rope, and he sticks it.
Cecil doubled over, penitent
here.
Two count, Cecil Cerveza just getting the shoulder up.
This crowd is just on their feet, standing for Harker Dirge.
He's trying to, he's feeding off that energy, John Stone.
Oh, and there's a back rake to Cecil.
Big boot.
Big boot up the ropes, going for his move. Reverse DDT, drops him down, pin attempt. Wait a minute. Oh, look at that. Dickie Wabash put Cecil's foot on the bottom rope.
The ref didn't see that, though. He put his foot on there.
Harker didn't realize what happened.
Dickie,
oh, he does now.
Shawn Rife. Hey, wait a minute. I think Dickie put something into the ring.
Dickie slid his cane into the ring. No. No.
What a shot to the side of the head.
He shot him in the side of the head with that cane. Pin attempt.
Cerveza! Oh my gosh!